national anthem is performed by the Marshfield Tiger Pep Band, set for basketball tonight. Marshfield and Rhinelander meeting in this non-conference matchup here at the Boson Company Fieldhouse. Before we get the ball game underway, let's check our starting lineups for tonight's ball game. A service of Stern Weiss and Sons and their block division, 400 East Arnold Street in Marshfield. The starting lineups for the Rhinelander Hodags for tonight. At center is Owen White, 6'5", senior, averaging 15 points per game. He'll play his college ball next season at Division II Michigan Tech. The forwards, Bach Leader, 6'1", junior, averaging 7 points per game. And Reese Flores, 5'10", senior, averaging 3.8. The guards are Brad Comer, 5'9", senior, averaging 8.2 points per game, and Junior Howard, 5'10", junior, averaging 8.5 points per game. Hodags coached by Derek Lemons, now in his seventh season. His record, 106 wins and 44 losses. He is assisted by Chad Bulkema and Jason Kramer. The Hodags are 7-1 overall and 2-0 in the Great Northern Conference. For the Marshfield Tigers tonight, at center, Grant Urban, 6'4", senior, averaging 1.6 points per game. The forward, Seth Anderson, 6'5", senior, averaging 19.9. And Isaac Miverdon, 6'4", sophomore, averaging 4.6. The guards are Brant Bowman, 5'10", junior, averaging 9.3 points per game. And Reed Miller, 6'6", junior, averaging 13.9 points per game. Tigers coached by Scott Scheuer in his third season as Tiger head coach. His record, 35-22. Assisted by Ryan Larson and Sean Lee, Tigers 5-4 overall, 2-1 in the Wisconsin Valley Conference. Rhinelander wins the tip and moves into front court to our left. Reese Flores holds out top. Comes to Owen White, top of the circle, outside the paint area. Comes back outside again to Brad Comer. Far side, Flores outside the arc. Tigers playing half-court man-to-man defense. Brock Leader in the circle. Turned away by Miller. Comer comes back out top again to Flores. They lob inside for White. Turns, comes back outside again for a three by Leader. He drives, lays it up and missed it, and pulled in by Reed Miller. And here's a foul on the breakout as Brad Comer reaches in on Reed Miller. First on Comer, first team foul. Tigers starting Grant Urban tonight, so they can have somebody just specialized defensively on Owen White. That's the reasoning for Grant starting. He handles the ball right now in front court. Comes outside to Seth Anderson. Skips it far side to Miller. Baseline to Bowman. 1-2-2 zone defense here by Rhinelander, just as Coach Scheuer expected. Miverdon on the far wing. Hands out top again to Bowman. High post, Anderson fakes the three, now drives down the lane. Kicks it back out to Miller. Cross court to Bowman. Downstairs, Miverdon comes back to Bowman on the cut. He drops the ball, taken away by White. Tiger turnover. Comer comes front court to Flores on the far wing. Comer back out top. He'll launch a three-pointer and miss the shot. And the rebound grabbed by Grant Urban. He played 90 seconds, still no score. Tiger ball. Miller out front, far side to Bowman. 1-2-2 zone by Rhinelander. Bowman brings it top of the key. Near side to Miller. Back out top again to Seth Anderson. He's had a great hot hand lately. Bowman baseline, fakes to three. Comes back outside to Miller. Right back to Brandt in the corner. Picked up by White down there along the baseline. Now Anderson on the drive to the foul line, turned away. Double teamed out there and comes back outside with it. Now has some defensive problems, but hands to Urban along the baseline. Skips across court to Miller. Reed with a long three-pointer from the wing. It's good. Miller for three, his 22nd three-point basket this season. Tigers lead by three. Rhinelander on the attack. Junior Howard across the line on Brad Bowman. Baseline to Owen White on the far side. Near wing to Flores. Dumps it baseline to Brock Leader in the corner. Turns on Anderson, drives, is stopped by Seth and drops the ball. Loose on the floor, picked up by Bowman. He'll hand to Urban, and Grant fouled on the breakout. And Urban leading the break down the floor. And a foul called here on Owen White, his first foul. Second team foul. Tigers inbound inside to Miller. Short jumper, missed it. Back gets his own rebound. Back up and missed it again. Back up and in this time by, I believe, Anderson. It is on Anderson. Anderson on the putback. And the Tigers lead by five. Rhinelander on the attack. Howard along the far sideline. Bounces to White, top of the key. Right back to Howard on the far wing. Off the screen to the circle. Turned away. Baseline Flores for three. Up and in. Reese Flores for three. Tiger lead down to two. And now Rhinelander with some full court pressure. 1-2-1-1 full court zone. Mivert in backcourt. Dribbles into a double team. Comes across line to Urban on the cut to Anderson, who drives and scores. Tigers break the press very nicely and go up by four. Rhinelander back down the floor. Flores along the far sideline. To the baseline, stopped by Anderson on the switch. Comer on the far wing, picked up by Miverton. Tigers playing half-court man-to-man. Here's White, top of the key. On the drive, spins on Urban. Turnaround from 10, up and in. Tough turnaround jump shot for Owen White. Rhinelander back to within two. They press again. Anderson in backcourt. Dribbles across the line. Baseline to Urban. Back to Seth on the cut. He'll drive and score. Tigers beating Rhinelander down the floor. And Marshfield back up by four. We've played 4 minutes. Rhinelander has the ball back. Howard across the line on Bowman. Gets a screen. Goes baseline. Goes all the way inside. His shot rejected by Miller and grabbed by Urban. Reed Miller on the block. Ahead to Anderson. Stopped in front court. Back out top Miller. Reed on the drive. In the lane. Pulls up 10 foot away. Around and out. Tipped around. A rebounding foul on Marshfield. Both Miller and Urban are there. Somebody over the back. Looks like it's going to be on Grant Urban. First on Grant, first team foul. Bryce Schickard comes in for Rhinelander, 6'3 junior. He's averaging 9.5 a game. Rhinelander back down the floor, trailing by four. Owen White out top. Junior Howard top of the circle now. Backs it out. Looks to White top of the key. Holds on Urban. Comes back near side to Howard. Off a screen by White to the foul line. Leans in, back to White. Open near side for three, up and in. Owen White with a three-pointer, giving him five tonight. Tiger lead down to one. Anderson in backcourt, holds the ball. Cross court to Miller, baseline to Bowman. Tigers break the press once again. Out front, Anderson. He'll launch a three-pointer. Good. Seth Anderson for three. And Seth has 9 points in the first 5 minutes tonight. Marshfield back up by four. 13 minutes to play in the first half. Rhinelander to forecourt. Howard near the center line. Flores comes baseline to Comer. On the cut downstairs, White is open down low. Lays it in and fouled as well. Owen White on the back door. Cut for two. Basket is good. And the foul on Grant Urban. Second foul on Grant and the second team foul. And that'll get Anthony Postolik off the Tiger bench. 6'1 sophomore, averaging 5.8 per game. Normally a starter. Anthony comes in. Owen White, foul line left, attempting a three-point play. White will play his college ball next season at Division II Michigan Tech. White ready. His foul shot up and in. So he's got 8 points so far this evening. And Rhinelander back to within one. They press again. Front court passes going down the floor, though, untouched out of bounds. A long pass up the floor towards Seth Anderson by Reed Miller, and Seth couldn't get there. Tigers bring Tommy Olson in the ballgame. 6'2 junior, averaging 3.8 per game. And Reed Miller will set. 12:45 left in the first half. Tigers lead 12-11, putting on pressure now. Comer across the line on Miverton. Bounces into White, turns on Anderson, leans in, left-hander up, around, and in. Owen White with 10 points in the first 5.5 minutes. And Rhinelander has its first lead at 13-12. Tigers dribble into front court. Anderson on the near wing. In the lane to Miverton. Kicks it back out to Seth. Cross-court Bowman, far corner. Now Postolik, top of the circle. Anthony looks around, finds Olson, baseline to Bowman. In the corner, Miverton turns, right back out to Bowman. Now Anderson in the lane, leans in and was hand-checked going to the basket. Rhinelander foul called on Junior Howard, his first, third team foul. Tigers inbound, baseline front court, Miverton will throw it in. Far side to Bowman. Brandt cuts to the basket, comes back out to Olsen. Bowman gets it back, waits for Anderson on the cut. Seth can't get free. Postolik right back to Anderson, near side, open for a three-pointer, off the lip and out, and rebounded by Owen White. Rhinelander has the ball, leading by one. White dribbles to front court. Stopped out top by Anderson. Far side, Flores. Downstairs, White again. Turns on Anderson. Fall away, jump shot, good. Owen White not missing. He's got 12 points in 6.5 minutes. And Rhinelander by three, their biggest lead. They put on some pressure, but Meverden dribbles to front court for the Tigers. Hands back outside to Postolik, near side to Bowman. Brand holds in the corner. Dribbles back outside on Flores. Olsen out near the center line. 1-2-2 half-court zone by Rhinelander. They extend out when they can. Bowman on the near sideline. Bounces into Anderson to the lane. Left-hander leans in and missed it. Tipped around and claimed by Howard of Rhinelander. Good scoring chance there for the Tigers. Flores to front court and has no advantage. Inside feed to Schickard. He'll turn. Left-hander goes up and missed it, but was fouled by Postolik. Anthony on the foul, his first third-team foul. Schickert, the one guy on this team aside from White with some size, he's 6'3 junior, and got posted up down low on Postolik. Big mismatch there for Rhinelander. Schickert shooting free throws. The first is in. 10:55 remaining first half. Tigers trail 16-12. Reed Miller back in for Brand Bowman. And Rhinelander brings in Brad Quaid, a 5'9 senior, averaging 8.5 a game. Tigers add John Riegel to the lineup. 5'11 senior, averaging 1.3. One more free throw for Schickert is away and missed and rebounded by Reed Miller. Tigers down by 4, 10:50 left in the first half. Marshfield on the attack. Anderson near side. Ball knocked around out of bounds. And the officials confer here. Ball will stay apparently with Marshfield. Last hit by a Rhinelander defender. Tigers inbound at quarter court, trailing by 4. Riegel throws in backcourt to Olsen. And Tommy will cross once again. Near side to Postolik. Anthony dribbles out top himself. Needs some help here. And lobs near side to Anderson outside the arc. Out front, Olsen swings to Postolik once again. Postolik looking around, comes to Anderson, top of the key. Olsen along the baseline. Man-to-man defense here by Rhinelander. Now Postolik far side, high post to Anderson. Can't get off the shot. Spins it back out to Miller in the corner. Reed can attack. Cross-court feed to Postolik once again. Right back to Miller. Out top, a three-pointer by Reed is away and good. Reed Miller hits a three. And we have a timeout. Rhinelander takes a timeout, their first of the ballgame. 9:57 remaining in the first half. Our score is Rhinelander 16, Marshfield 15. Coverage of Marshfield Tiger basketball this evening on WDLB, a service of the Dental Clinic of Marshfield, S&S Insurance of Marshfield, and the Marshfield Tiger Hoops Club. Tigers led early by 5. Rhinelander has come back, and they've led by as much as 4. They're up by 1 here. 9:57 remaining in the first half. Tigers out with Postolik, Riegel, Olsen, Miller, and Anderson. Rhinelander coming length of the floor, leading by 1. Brad Comer will throw it in. Junior Howard takes over in backcourt, starts out on Reed Miller. Seth Anderson down low, defending Owen White. Comer on the back door cut, a wide open lay-in by Brad Quaid. Quaid on the back door cut for 2. And Rhinelander back up by 3. They press again in backcourt. Riegel has it. Bounces ahead to Anderson. Set to front court to the near side. Down the lane, cut off. And a reach-in foul coming. Rhinelander player grabbing the basketball, but got the arm as well. That's going to be on Brad Comer. Second foul on Comer, fourth team foul. So Brock Leader back in for Comer. Tigers inbounding, baseline front court, 9:30 left, first half. Tigers down 18-15, lob up for Anderson at the high post. Seth double teamed out there. comes back out front to Postolik. Far side, Miller along the sideline, dribbles back out front. Rhinelander's defense quite aggressive, double teaming on the outside. Miller needs some help, finds Riegel at the far hash mark. Sean starts to attack. Now he's double teamed, needs some help, finds Miller on the near side, baseline Postolik. Anthony back outside again to Miller. Miller lobs far side to Anderson to the baseline. On the cut to Riegel, knocked away and stolen by Rhinelander. Tiger turnover. Howard comes to front court, holds on the far wing, picked up by Miller. Tigers playing man-to-man. Miller top of the circle to the near side. Baseline hits Quaid. Looks downstairs to Schickert, knocked down by Riegel, goes out of bounds, and last hit by John. Isaac Miverton back in for Marshfield for John Riegel with 8:40 remaining in the first half. And the Tigers trailing 18-15. Marshfield inbounding at quarter court. Miverton comes in to Postolik. And Anthony crosses the timeline on leader. Now double teamed on the outside. Anderson on the near wing. Lobs out top again. Miverton baseline, a three by Postolik, around and out. Tipped up and in by Anderson. Seth Anderson on the tip-in. Tigers back in by one. Here's Rhinelander to front court. Howard, top of the key. Far side to Schickert, outside the arc. Downstairs, White turns on Anderson, leans in. Left-hander is up and no good. And rebounded by Anderson. White doesn't miss very often. Front court feed comes to Miverton. The backdoor cut to Anderson, who drives and scores. Anderson from Miverton, and the Tigers go back up by one. 7:50 remaining in the first half. Rhinelander on offense. Howard pushing far side to White to the foul line. Backs in, comes back outside to leader. Can't get off the three. Attacks the lane and gets caught up in traffic and walks with the basketball. You're listening to Marshfield Tiger Basketball on AM 1450 WDLB Marshfield and WDLB WOSQ.com. Tom Uthmeyer is our producer. I'm Gene DeLisio at the Boson Company Fieldhouse in Marshfield. Tigers lead by one, 7:35 remaining in the first half. Ball knocked away from Postolik. Loose on the floor, picked up by Miverton. He lost it, but grabbed again by Postolik. Tigers reset. Baseline Miller. Back out top Miverton. Far side Riegel. Downstairs hits Anderson. He gets hit and fouled down low. Call here against Rhinelander. Gets on Bryce Schickert. His first foul. Fifth team foul. Tommy Olson back in for Ethan Postolik in the Marshfield lineup. Tigers to inbound. Baseline front court. Here's Junior Howard back in for Rhinelander for Bryce Schickert. Pretty small Rhinelander Bonklin out there without Schickert. White is 6'5", no one else more than 6'1". Inbound pass to Miller on the far wing. Bowman back out top, right back to Miller. Top of the circle, Anderson swings near side to Olson. Bowman from the corner, can't get off a shot. Back outside, a three-pointer by Miverton off the back of the rim, no good. And pulled in by Brock Leader. Rhinelander has it back. Howard rushing to front court. Stopped on the far wing, so he'll take a three and miss the shot. And Bowman goes high to grab the rebound from Marshfield. Brand stopped in backcourt. He'll cross to Anderson. Seth in the center circle, right back to Bowman on the near wing. 6:50 in the period. Tigers by one. Miverton right back to Bowman in the along the baseline. Facing a double team, drills back outside again. Anderson far hash mark. Seth holds the ball, starts to attack on Flores. Baseline Miller, Reed open for a three-pointer. It's offline, but picked up by Miverton. Back out to Anderson for a three-pointer, and this one's good. Seth Anderson on the three off the offensive rebound by Miverton, and Marshfield goes back up by four. Anderson already has 16 here in the first half. Rhinelander on the attack. Howard comes near side to White. One-on-one with Anderson. He'll go to the baseline. Lean in. Force the shot up. No good, but fouled. White's a left-hander. Makes him tough to guard. And Seth Anderson gets the foul call. His first. Fourth team foul. Owen White. Foul line left. Shooting two for Rhinelander. White will play his college ball next year at Michigan Tech. That's where Kyle Stankowski of Mosin E played for a 4 years. First free throw by White is good. Brad Comer back in for Rhinelander. Quaid is out. 6:10 remaining first half. Marshfield on top, 22-19. Second free throw by White, around and in. So White has 14 in the first half. Seth Anderson has 16. Marshfield leads by two. Rhinelander pressing once again. Anderson will cross the timeline on the near sideline. In the lane to Meverden. Kicks back out to Miller. Reed swings it back to Anderson. Threw his hands, out of bounds. Tigers turn the ball over. Marshfield's fourth turnover tonight. Rhinelander back on the attack. They can tie with a basket. 5:50 left before halftime. Flores on the far wing. Dumps it baseline. A three-pointer by Comer, up and no good. Tipped around. Flores has it back down low, but he's in too deep. Lobs it back outside again to Comer. Here's Howard, top of the key for three, up and in. So Junior Howard hits the three off the offensive rebound. And Rhinelander goes back up by one. They press in backcourt once again. Miller has the ball, ahead to Anderson. Back to Reed. He'll cross the timeline. Far side to Bowman. Brand picked up by Flores. Top of the circle, Howard, or to Olsen rather. Defense by Howard. Miller, far side, Bowman in the corner. Can't get off the three. Goes back outside again. Reed Miller swings back to Anderson. To the baseline. Stop down low. Turns. Leans in. Drops the ball. Gets it back. Kicks out to Bowman. Three-pointer by Brandt. Away. No good. Long rebound. Lost by Olsen and grabbed by Flores. Ahead to Howard. A breakout for Rhinelander. Howard stops top of the circle. Picked up by Bowman. Gets a screen from White to the foul line. Kicks back out. Baseline to Flores. Comer fakes the long three on Meverden. Near side White, he'll try a three-pointer and miss it, and Miller screens off to grab the rebound. Tigers have it back. Miller across the 10-second line, bumping with Comer, 4.5 in the period. Reed down the lane, leans in, shoots, and scores. Reed Miller attacks for two, and Marshfield goes back up by one. Rhinelander on the attack. Owen White along the far sideline. He'll lob it downstairs to nobody. Throws the ball right past Leader, out of bounds. Rhinelander's third turnover. Bryce Schickert back in for Rhinelander, and White gets a rest. 4:17 remaining, first half. Tigers on top, 24-23. Backcourt pressure. Meverden with the ball in backcourt. Still dribbling. Ahead to Miller. Across the line to Bowman. Near side Anderson. Seth goes baseline. Leans in and scores again. Boy, the Tigers have really capitalized on the Rhinelander press tonight. They're back up by three. Anderson has 16 already. 3:55 remaining in the first half. It's Rhinelander ball. Leader in the far corner. Drives on Meverden. Gets inside and drops the ball out of bounds. Back-to-back turnovers for Rhinelander. Hodags press once again. Rhinelander in a 1-2-2 zone. Bowman in backcourt. Dribbles across the timeline. Baseline to Olsen. Tommy pops a three-pointer. Off the rim, no good. And Flores screens off Anderson for the rebound. Comes near side to Comer. He'll hold outside the arc. Downstairs, Schickert turns on Olsen. Inside to Leader. Comes right back out to Schickert. Leader couldn't shoot the ball over Anderson. Leader has it back on the near wing. Now lobs in for Schickert down low. He'll force the shot, and Meverden slaps it out of bounds. Last hit by Meverden. It's Rhinelander ball. Owen White right back in for Rhinelander. Replacing Brock Leader with 3:20 remaining in the first half. Marshfield on top, 26-23. Rhinelander inbounding. Pass comes near side to Comer. He'll fire a three-pointer and nail it. Three-pointer for Rhinelander. Ties the game at 26. That's our first tie. 3:10 remaining in the first half. Miller in backcourt, double teamed. Still in backcourt. Now dribbles across the line through traffic. Baseline to Olsen, drives inside and lays it in and fouled as well. Tommy Olsen cuts to the basket for two off the feed from Reed Miller. Basket is good. And the foul called on Bryce Schickert. His second, sixth team foul. Leader coming right back in for Schickert for Rhinelander. And Quaid back in as well for Flores. Tommy Olsen, 4 of 5 on the foul line this season. Line right attempting a three-point play for Marshfield. And the foul shot away off the back of the rim and missed. And knocked around by Meverden, out of bounds. And that ball was grabbed by Leader. Then Meverden slapped the ball out of his hands and out of bounds off Leader. Heads up play there by Isaac Meverden. We may have a foul as well here. I believe we have a foul on Leader, as the two scrambled for the loose ball. Leader knocked down Mefferton. First foul on Bryce Leader, seventh team foul, and that puts Marshfield into the bonus. Isaac Mefferton only shooting 35% on the foul line this year, but he is lying right for 1-1. Mefferton set, and his first free throw is good. With 3 minutes to play in the first half, Marshfield leading 29-26. Neither team is led by more than five so far tonight. One more free throw for Isaac Mefferton. Shot is away and also good. Tigers go up by four, putting on some pressure in backcourt. Comer has the ball up the near sideline. Picked up by Mefferton. He'll cross the timeline to the near side, down the lane all the way. One-hander up and around and out. Tipped outside, and a rebounding collision here between Miller and Comer. And this might go on Comer. He went down. He got the worst of the collision, but it was his action that caused the collision. And that should be three fouls on Brad Comer. That is his third, eighth team foul. And Reed Miller on the foul line, where he shoots 74% for the year. Reed with a 1-1 bonus here. Reed, 8 points so far tonight. Miller set. First free throw, good. 2:47 remaining, first half. Tigers lead 31-26. This matches Marshfield's biggest lead. Reed Miller with a second free throw. And the shot is away and short and pulled in by Owen White of Rhinelander. Hodags back up the floor, trailing by five. Comer off a screen from Flores on the near wing. Bounces into White on the cut inside to Comer. In too deep, short jumper rolls in, however. And so Rhinelander does score it. Rhinelander back to within three. Long inbound pass deflected by Flores. Thrown back on the floor and stolen by Rhinelander. However, we may have an over and back call here, as that ball was thrown back on the floor to Quade, who had to take it in backcourt, then recross again. So a double turnover there. And Marshfield has the ball back at the center line, leading by three. Miller moves back across the timeline. Near side hits Bowman. Ball slapped loose, out of bounds. And last hit by Quade. Marshfield inbounding at quarter court. Mefferton throws in to Miller near the center line. Near side Bowman once again. High post Anderson. Turns on White. Baseline Bowman. Three-point try is up. Off the rim and no good. Ball's on the floor and claimed by White. 2 minutes in the period. Ahead to Howard on the far side. Back out front, Quade. Far side, White. Starts to drive. Kicks out baseline. A three by Leader up and in. Brock Leader hits his first three of the night. And we're tied at 31. 1:40 left in the first half. Rhinelander with pressure. Miller in backcourt. Ahead to Anderson. Front court to Mefferton. Isaac to the baseline. Turned away. Knocks a man down for a charge. Mefferton runs over Brad Quade for a charge. First foul on Isaac. Fifth team foul. Tigers' sixth turnover. Anthony Postolik back in for Marshfield for Mefferton. And Rhinelander can regain the lead with 92 seconds in the period. Junior Howard has the basketball. Starts out on Isaac Mefferton. And he'll cross the 10-second line. Holds it out front. White on the cut downstairs to Leader, forcing the shot up, and it rolls out of there, tipped outside, and claimed by Tommy Olson. Marshfield on the run out. Now Tommy harassed in front court. Ball comes loose on the floor, picked up by Flores. Rhinelander gets it right back again. White dribbles back to front court. One-on-one with Anderson. Starts to attack at the foul line cutoff. Goes back out to Quade. He'll drive, short jumper, rejected by Miller. Grabbed by Mefferton. Right back to Miller. Tigers come back to front court. Olsen in the near corner. 45 seconds in the period. Olsen double team, comes back to Miller. Back door cut to Mefferton. He's open down low, but in too deep. Kicks out to Anderson once again. Seth on the drive, in the lane, leans in. One-hander up and in. Seth Anderson scores it. Tigers back up by two. 30 seconds remaining in the first half. Rhinelander to front court. Junior Howard near the center line. Picked up by Miverton. High post White. Ball tipped away from him, however. Comes back out in the corner to Quade. Has no shot. Comes back out to White. 10 on the clock. As we close out the first half, Marshfield by two. Clock down to seven. White near the center line. Drives on Anderson. Pulls up at the foul line. Comes back out to Howard. A three-point try up and no good. Rebound to Miller as time expires. And a very competitive first half of basketball here at the Boson Company Fieldhouse in Marshfield. Once again, Tiger basketball this evening on WDLB, a service of the Baldus Bread and Butter Shops in Marshfield. When you gas up at the Marshfield Tiger or Columbus Don's Pride Pumps on North Central Avenue next to Walgreens, 2 cents per gallon is donated to that school system. That's at the Baldus Bread and Butter Shop next to Walgreens on North Central Avenue in Marshfield. Our halftime score here at the Boson Company Fieldhouse in Marshfield, the Marshfield Tigers 33, Rhinelander 31. We'll come back with our halftime program following these messages.
When it comes to financial decisions, it's good to know that First Choice Credit Union in Marshfield has all the services needed in today's fast-paced economy. And at this time of the year, it's a good time to start a Christmas Club account. Dividends are paid quarterly, and your account will be paid out to you the first week of November, just in time for your Christmas shopping. Saving money for Christmas all year long. What a concept! First Choice Credit Union serves all who live or work in Wood, Marathon, Clark, and Portage counties and their immediate families. First Choice Credit Union.
Member NCUA, an equal opportunity lender.
Every team needs the right connection to succeed. The same thing applies to your home or business. If something doesn't seem quite right, don't play amateur repair person. Contact Total Electric Service of Marshfield at 384-3311. Total Electric offers a 24-hour emergency service for residential, commercial, farm, and industrial jobs. Total Electric Service, the name says it all. Total service for all of your electric contracting needs. 384-3311.
An excellent team is built from the ground up. It starts with a solid foundation, support among its members, and the development of a winning tradition. If you're planning to build or remodel, think of the tradition offered at Trudeau Construction of Marshfield. They handle everything from new homes to additions, remodeling projects, kitchens and baths, cabinets, wood floors, decks, and gazebos. Have a project in mind? Plan it from the ground up by dialing 387-2239 for Trudeau Construction, Marshfield.
Halftime score here at the Boson Company Fieldhouse in Marshfield. Marshfield 33, Rhinelander 31. UW Marshfield men's basketball team plays at UW Fox Valley tomorrow evening. Game time for that one, 7:30. In women's college basketball action tomorrow night, UW Stevens Point women at the Berg Gym in Stevens Point against River Falls. Game time, 7 p.m. UW Oshkosh women, coached by Marshfield's Brad Fisher, will play in UW Whitewater tomorrow evening. UW Stout women, featuring Athens Kincaid Diedrich, will play at Platteville tomorrow night. And former Columbus Don standout Abby Byroll now back on the floor. Abby played last year for Franciscan University in Ohio. Missed the first semester this season as she was studying in Europe, but now she is back in Ohio and playing for Franciscan. They'll take on Pitt Greensburg in a ball game in Steubenville tomorrow evening. The Carroll College of Waukesha women, featuring a former Northland Lutheran standout Hannah Klein from Marshfield, will play North Park of Illinois tomorrow in Waukesha. And the Luther of Iowa women, coached by Mosinese Amanda Nahuda, will play at Simpson tomorrow evening in women's college basketball. Our halftime score here at the Boson Company Fieldhouse in Marshfield is Marshfield 33, Rhinelander 31. We'll come back and review the first half scoring and stats following these messages.
The cozy warmth after coming in from a chilly pink-cheeked morning walk. The perfect man cave temperature to kick back and watch the big game. When the weather turns cold, a new Rheem heating system will surround your family in total comfort. Are you feeling it? Rheem, the new degree of comfort.
Feel the warmth this winter with a new home heating system installed by the local pros at Comfort Systems Heating and Cooling. Call Comfort Systems Heating and Cooling today or see them in Marshfield at 1209 West Veterans Parkway.
I bet I know what you're not thinking about right now. Safety issues when it comes to water and electricity. Thank goodness Marshfield Utilities has done some thinking for you. Of course, it's up to you to follow through with smart thinking about things like to prevent scalding water, heaters should be set no higher than 120 degrees. Always dry your hands before using a switch, plug, or electrical outlet. Stay away from fenced-in power stations, utility poles, and towers. Get all the facts about water and electric safety from Marshfield Utilities. Safety is important, don't you think?
The next time you need a plumber, call Schreiner's Plumbing and Heating of Marshfield. Schreiner's Plumbing has licensed plumbers, and they've been offering fast, dependable service to the Marshfield area for nearly 100 years. They do it all, from pump service and installation to water heaters, water softeners, sewer, and drain cleaning. They have kitchen and bath fixtures, too. Come see their showroom to give your home a bold new look with Kohler. When you need a plumber, don't settle for anything less. Call the best. Schreiner's Plumbing and Heating, 106 East 4th Street in Marshfield.
Tight ball game this evening for the Marshfield Tiger boys basketball team. Tigers facing Rhinelander tonight at the Boson Company Fieldhouse in Marshfield. Tigers lead here at halftime 33-31. Our halftime stats, a service of the people for whom numbers matter the most. Edward Jones Investments of Marshfield. See Randy Gershman or Brian Kaiser for their sound investment advice. Rhinelander halftime led by their standout post player Owen White with 14 of their 31 points so far this evening. Junior Howard has 2 threes for 6. Brad Quay, 2 baskets for 4. Reese Flores and Brock Leader each with a 3-point basket for 3. And Bryce Schickert has a free throw for 1. Marshfield led by Seth Anderson. 18 points for Seth Anderson here in the first half. 8 baskets and 2 threes. Seth averaging 25.8 points per game in Marshfield's previous 4 contests. He certainly has had the hot hand for the Marshfield Tigers in recent ball games. 25 against Eau Claire North before the break. 30 against Merrill. 19 against Rapids. 29 against Smash. So Seth with some big offensive numbers and on his way to a big night once again tonight with 18 points. Reed Miller with 9. Isaac Miverton and Tommy Olson each with 2. Tigers 3 of 5 on the foul line. Rhinelander 4 of 5. Marshfield 7 turnovers. Rhinelander 5. 2 ties at 26 and 31. And 4 lead changes so far this evening. Our halftime score is Marshfield 33. Rhinelander 31. And more from the Boson Company Fieldhouse in just a moment.
Business insurance. If you own a business, you need coverage. Talk to the experts at Schwartz Insurance. Over 90 years experience and 3 generations of family ownership. Let Schwartz manage your business insurance program. Schwartz Insurance. Be sure. Check out Schwartz at BeSureOnline.com. That's BeSureOnline.com. Or call 387-1130. Schwartz Insurance. Be sure.
Here's another tooth truth from Dental Clinic of Marshfield.
Dental Clinic of Marshfield helps people rest easier. Sleep problems related to breathing aren't just bothersome. They can be dangerous. Snoring and sleep apnea may be managed with help from your dentist at Dental Clinic of Marshfield.
Dental Clinic of Marshfield, dental care for life. Schedule an appointment today at any of their 3 offices in Marshfield, Stratford, or Neillsville. Learn more at dentalclinicofmarshfield.com.
The Tiger Hoops Club thanks the Marshfield community. Your support helps to offset tournament fees and travel expenses for basketball travel teams grades 4 through 8. Go to TigerHoopsClub.com to see information on upcoming events, fundraisers, team photos, and upcoming tournaments. Thanks to Tiger Hoops Club sponsors, including Marshfield Clinic, Mid-State Truck Service, Marshfield Firefighters, Forward Financial Bank, Marshfield Professional Police Association, V&H Truck, and WDLB WOSQ Radio. Come on out to high school basketball games and support the Marshfield Tiger basketball teams. Roll Tigers.
Roll Tiger.
Roll Tiger.
Back here at the Fieldhouse on Thursday night for Tiger girls basketball. Marshfield and DCF is Thursday at 7:15. Our broadcast Thursday at 7 p.m. right here on WDLB. Our halftime score, Marshfield 33, Rhinelander 31. Back with the second half of basketball in just a moment.
Are you tired of pressing buttons only to talk to a machine? Then it's time to switch to a local insurance agency. Someone you know and trust to be there for you and your family. S&S Insurance at 207 West Upham Street in Marshfield has been serving the area since 1985. S&S Insurance Services can tailor any auto, home, life, business, or farm policy to fit your life. Call S&S Insurance for a free quote today at 715-387-3477 or stop by and visit one of their experienced agents at 207 West Upham Street in Marshfield. Whether you're looking for top quality flooring, window treatments, expert installation, or professional design advice, you'll find it all and more at Rice's Capital Carpet. Over 300 years of combined sales and installation experience, we are dedicated to providing our clients with the absolute best in product and service. We cordially invite you to stop in, take a look around, ask questions, and then let our friendly and knowledgeable sales staff help you make an informed decision. Rice's Capital Carpet, Highway 13 North in Marshfield, or call Rice's Capital Carpet today, 715-384-4550.
Looking for the best home for the money? Check with the pros at REMAX American Dream Realty in Marshfield.
The long winter days with less light can be dreary. If you want to get extra cozy this cold season, Better Homes and Gardens has some tips for you. If you have an outdoor room that you love, add a fire pit to throw off heat and light. Boost your brightness by adding up lights for a little extra shine. And here's another quick tip. Check the quality of the light in the bulbs you use. Bulbs with a high color rendering index give the truest light.
This tip from REMAX American Dream Realty in Marshfield.
Tiger ball in front court to our left as we start the second half. Marshfield up by two here at the halftime break. Zone defense by Rhinelander. Meverden on the far wing. Lobs out top to Seth Anderson. Far side, Reed Miller outside the arc. Meverden looking in for Urban, not free. Grant starting the second half again. Grant has the ball in the near corner. Shovels outside again to Anderson, top of the circle. Seth turns in the circle, backs it out. Now lobs in for Urban, knocked loose on the floor. Flores has it. Urban takes it away. Shovels out to Bowman for a three-pointer, and he missed it. Ball in the corner and grabbed by Flores. Rhinelander on the attack, looking to tie the ball game. Howard to Flores on the near side. Man-to-man defense by Marshfield. Howard has it back for a three-point try and no good. Seth Anderson there for the rebound for Marshfield. Tigers have it back, leading by two. Seth on the far wing, stopped, comes out top to Miller. Reed near the center circle holds it. Far side to Meverden. On the cut to Anderson. Foul line jumper up and in, and he's fouled as well. Somebody kind of hacked his arm as Seth released the pass, or the, released the shot, rather. And Seth Anderson with 20 points here in just over 19 minutes of play. That foul is on Brad Comer, and Comer now has four fouls. First team foul, Bryce Sheckert back in. Seth Anderson has hit the 20-point mark for the sixth time this year. And he is lying left attempting a three-point play. Anderson ready. Foul shot is up and in. Tigers up by five. This matches Marshfield's biggest lead. 16:50 left in regulation time. Rhinelander to front court. Howard off a screen comes to the near side of the baseline. Stopped by Bowman. Back outside to Owen White. Flores far side hits a leader. Back out front, Howard once again. Baseline White goes baseline, stopped by Urban. Nice job by Grant. Schickert looks in near side, back out top. A wide open three by Leader. Rims out of there and pulled in by Grant Urban. Marshfield has the ball, leading by five. Far side Anderson drives inside, leans in, knocks down two guys, and is called for a charge. Seth saw an opening, but it evaporated quickly. And Seth calling for the offensive foul. Second foul on Seth, first team foul, Marshfield's eighth turnover. Marshfield up by five early second half, and Rhinelander coming length of the floor. Tigers applying full court pressure here. Flores inbounding, the much bigger Reed Miller shadowing him, now ahead to White. White starts out on Grant Urban. Moves across the 10-second line, drives to the free throw line, down the lane, and drops the ball. Now, the official on the outside is going to call a foul here. I think Scott Scheuer believed that ball just came loose naturally. But a foul is called on Grant Urban, his third foul. Second team foul. Rhinelander inbounding, baseline front court. Here's a lob up for White in the lane, 10-footer short. And Meverden fights off two men for the rebound. Tough inside rebound there for Isaac Meverden. Marshfield to front court. Anderson drops the ball, comes back out to Miller. Reed holds on the far wing. Lobs out top to Bowman. Facing a trap out front. Far side Miller once again. Reed drives the near side to the circle. Kicks back out to Bowman. Baseline Anderson. Three-pointer up and off the rim. No good. A fight for the rebound. Miller has it back up and in. Tough inside rebound for Reed Miller. And Marshfield up by 7. This is Marshfield's biggest lead. Tigers applying some pressure as Howard moves to front court for the Hodags. Goes baseline on Bowman. Comes back out. A three-pointer by Leader. Rims out of there. Miller right there for the rebound. 7 rebounds for Reed tonight. Marshfield back up the floor. Anderson baseline to Bowman on the cut to Anderson. Drops it, but picked up by Urban. He gives to Bowman, who drives and scores. Grant Urban in the right spot to grab the basketball and pass off for an assist. And we have a Rhinelander timeout. Hodags use their second timeout. 15:05 remaining in regulation time. And our score, Marshfield 40, Rhinelander 31. More basketball in just a moment.
Paget Equipment Company, a division of JBL International, specializing in stainless steel fabrication worldwide and a proud backer of Marshfield area youth programs and activities. The folks at Paget Equipment support healthy competition. It helps prepare youth for life, teaching them important concepts like teamwork and fair play. Important in athletics, important in business, important in life. Paget Equipment, a strong backer of the youth of Marshfield, urging you to get involved with school-related activities.
In these days of fast-paced lives and fast-talking salespeople, it's nice to know you can still count on your local Dish-authorized retailer, Selk Electronics, with folks right here in your neighborhood to tell you the honest truth. Dish simply costs less for the very same channels for your home or your business. Dish and Selk Electronics have it at a reasonable price with old-fashioned service. Believe it. Call Selk Electronics at 715-683-2558 today and experience an expert who's happy to answer all your questions, whatever they may be. Restrictions apply. Call for details.
Tigers open up a 9-point lead, 15:05 remaining in the second half. Rhinelander inbounding at three-quarter court. Marshfield with some backcourt pressure. Jared Haug now in the ball game for Rhinelander. He's a senior guard. Holds the ball in front court, comes out top to junior Howard. Picked up by Bowman. Howard bounces near side to Haug. Defense by Anderson. Back out top, White. A three-point try up and in. Owen White for three, his second tonight. White now with 17. Tiger lead is at 6 with 14:40 remaining. Miller in backcourt facing a trap. Comes across the line. Tigers have handled this quite well tonight. Miller picks up his dribble. Baseline Urban. Grant open down low. Forcing the shot. It rolls out of there, though. And pulled in by White. Rhinelander has it back. They're back to within 6. White across the line. Hands to Howard between the circles. Far side Flores with it. Baseline White. Drives on Urban in the lane. Pulls up. Fadeaway jump shot up and in. Boy, a tough shot for Owen White. He's got 19 and Rhinelander within 4. Miller facing a trap again. He'll cross the timeline on Haug. Spins out top. Facing a double team now. Bob's near side to Bowman. Ran along the sideline. He's double teamed. Needs some help along the sideline. Penetrates, goes inside to Anderson, but the ball never got there. Stolen by White. Rhinelander has it back up the floor. Flores on the near side. At the foul line, stopped. Back outside White for a very long three, and good again. A downtown three for Owen White. He's brought Rhinelander back to within 1 with 8 straight points. And that 9-point Tiger lead has evaporated. Now Marshfield has it back, and Anderson drops the ball out of bounds along the sideline. Postolik and Riegel back in for Marshfield. .13:23 remaining in regulation time. Marshfield leads 40-39. Tigers led by 9 moments ago. That lead now down to 1, and Rhinelander can reclaim the lead with a basket. Howard moves into front court for Rhinelander. Haug on the far wing. Brings it back outside again to Quade. He'll drive to the foul line. Turned away by Anderson. White out front once again. Near side, Quade can't get off the shot. He'll drive in the lane. Short jumper rolls around. Falls in. Rhinelander has scored 10 straight. And they grab a 1-point lead. 12:55 left. And here's a Tiger turnover. Anderson lost control and White takes it away. Up the floor to Howard on the far side. Back out top, Quade once again. Right back to Howard on the far wing. Quade top of the key, fakes the three, gives to Haug on the near side. Haug can't drive the lane. Far side, Howard has it back once more. Looking baseline to Quade, turns in the corner. Spins on Miller, stopped by Reed. White gets it back, now back out front once again. A lot of outside passing. Haug baseline turned away by Riegel. Haug still in the corner. Looking downstairs for Schicker, turns, shoots over Meverden. Missed a wild shot, but Isaac fouled him. Second on Meverden, third team foul. Wisconsin Badger basketball team won its game with Indiana tonight, 71-61. Free throws for Schickert. First is good. 12:15 remaining in regulation time. Tigers now trail 42-40. 11 straight points here for Rhinelander. Second free throw for Schickert is away and also good. And Rhinelander up by three. Miverton in backcourt. He'll cross the timeline. Near side to Olsen. Tigers need some offense here. Meverden on the cut to Anderson. He falls down, but a foul called here on Rhinelander. Badgers win tonight, 71-61. Meverden inbounding, baseline front court. Lob out top to Anderson. Far side, Postolik lines up a three. It rims out, tipped up and missed by Meverden. Comes out long and grabbed by Rhinelander. Run out for Howard. Olsen down behind the play. Now he gets up and joins the fracas. Here's a driving attempt by Quade, missed by Rhinelander. Olsen now limping back to the bench, and Bowman will come in to replace him. Postolik gets the foul. Second on Anthony, third team foul. Free throws for Quade. His first try is good. Bowman back in for Postolik. 11:50 remaining in regulation time, and Rhinelander leads 44-40. Hodags have scored 13 straight points. Quade's second foul shot is also good. And a five-point lead for Rhinelander, their biggest. Meverden hustling to front court for Marshfield. Bowman near side, baseline to Postolik. Inside to Bowman, comes back out to Anthony. Postolik on the near wing, double team. Now finds Anderson in the center circle. 1-3-1 zone here by Rhinelander. Postolik, harass out top, gives to Anderson. Far side to Bowman. Grand double team, baseline to Riegel, through his legs out of bounds. And Reed Miller back in for Brant Bowman. Ethan Happ, 28 points and 9 rebounds for Wisconsin in that win tonight over Indiana. Rhinelander scored 14 straight points. They're up by 5. And they have the ball back with 11:10 to play. Owen White in front court, picked up by Anderson. Far side to Howard, down the lane, cut off, and throws the ball out of bounds, but tipped away by Riegel. Rhinelander maintains possession. Hodags inbound at quarter court, leading now by 5. 11:05 left in regulation time. Haug inbounds to White in the corner. Drives on Anderson in the lane and walks with the ball. Sixth Rhinelander turnover. Rhinelander with a 14-0 run after Marshfield took a 9-point lead. Marshfield back to front court. Anderson goes back door, and a jump shot, short jumper by Riegel is blocked. Comes back outside again to Quade. Rhinelander has it back. Quade far side, hits Howard outside the arc. Haug on the far wing, picked up by Riegel. Downstairs, White leans in, forcing the shot. It's good again. Owen White with 24, and Marshfield wants a timeout. Tigers take a timeout with 10:30 remaining in regulation time, and our score is Rhinelander 47 and the Marshfield Tigers 40. And we'll come back with more basketball in just a moment.
No matter whose name is on the door, it's the person you deal with that really matters. That one-on-one relationship is what Citizens State Bank of Loyal is built on. We are a local bank. Decisions are made locally, loans are serviced locally, and if you have a question, you know who to ask. If you are looking to make some improvements around your home, upgrade, refinance, maybe add on, talk to one of the local folks at Citizens State Bank of Loyal, Branson, Nielsville, Spencer, or Marshfield. We're just down the street.
If beauty, style, and efficiency are important to you, Heat & Glow has the fireplace for your home. As the leader in the industry, Heat & Glow has the most innovative designs and award-winning fireplaces. Heat & Glow offers hundreds of designs, all equipped with the most advanced technologies the 21st century has to offer. No one builds a better fire.
See the entire line of Heat & Glow options today at House of Heating, North Central Avenue in Marshfield.
Well, Marshfield led by 9 since then. Rhinelander has scored 16 straight points, and Rhinelander leads by 7. Hodak's pressing. Marshfield comes to front court. Anderson outside the arc. Baseline to Meverden. Backdoor cut to Bowman. He's in too deep. Kicks out to Miller. Posilic right back to Miller on the far wing. Baseline Anderson. Three-pointer by Seth. No good. And the rebound grabbed downstairs by Posilic. Back outside again, Miller. Here's Bowman near side. Three-point try up and no good. Ball in the corner. Meverden throws it back on the floor, and Bowman grabs it again. Miller back out front on the drive. Down the lane, leans in. Shot blocked by White and grabbed by Howard. Rhinelander on the run out. White top of the key. Down the lane, leans in. Short jumper off the glass, no good. And the rebound claimed by Anderson. Tigers go the other way. Lead from Miller. He'll drive, lay it in, and fouled as well. Reed Miller on the long feed from Seth Anderson. Basket good by Reed. Foul is called on Junior Howard of Rhinelander. His second team foul. That breaks a 16-0 run for Rhinelander. And puts Marshfield back to within 5. Reed Miller foul line left, attempting a three-point play. And the shot is away and no good. Rebound cleared by Haug of Rhinelander. 9:40 left, Tigers down by 5. Rhinelander ball in front court to our right. White far side to Quade. Howard looks in from the far wing. Near side, Haug has the basketball. Back out top, Quade down the lane. Leans in, scoop shot, rejected out of bounds by Miller. Brad Comer with 4 fouls coming back in for Rhinelander. For Jared Haug, 9:20 remaining in regulation time. Tigers trail 47-42. Rhinelander inbounding baseline front court from the corner. Here's a three-pointer by Howard. It's good. Junior Howard with his 3rd 3 of the ball game. 8-point lead for Rhinelander, their biggest lead. They put on backcourt pressure. Meverden backcourt ahead to Posilic. Double-teamed across the timeline. Lobs near side to Miller. Reed comes baseline to Bowman. 2-3 zone here by Rhinelander. Posilic on the far wing. Rhinelander usually plays zone. Near side, Bowman outside the arc. Brings it back out front once again. Near side, Posilic can't get off a shot. And here's a whistle away from the ball on Marshfield. Moving screen on the Tigers. Appears to be on Meverden. Isaac's 3rd foul, 4th team foul. Tigers 13th turnover. Rhinelander has only 6. Rhinelander has the ball back. They lead by 8. Ball loose on the floor, picked up by Miller. Back to the basket. Layup is no good, but Reed knocked down. And a foul called as well. And this might be a charge on Reed. That will be the call. Reed Miller knocks down a Rhinelander man. After the steal, first foul on Reed, 5th team foul. Tigers held a 9-point lead. Nothing's gone right since. Rhinelander now up by 8, 8:30 to play. Rhinelander ball. In the corner, Howard. 3-point try up and no good. Long rebound comes outside. Anderson after it. He'll grab it. Throw it back on the floor. It's loose at the timeline and picked up by White. Rhinelander has it right back. White passing far side to Howard. Pass near side, stolen by Bowman. Brandt has a run out. He'll drive down the floor and lay it in. Steal and basket for Brandt Bowman. And Marshfield back to within 6 with 8:05 to play. Hodag's ball. Quade on the near side. Hands to Schickert. Far side. Here's a three-pointer by Comer. Up and missed. Tipped in the corner. Grabbed by Schickert, but he can't control it. Goes out of bounds to Marshfield. Tigers down by six with 7:55 remaining. And we have a Marshfield timeout. Tigers use their second timeout, 7:53 remaining in regulation time. Our score is Rhinelander 50 and the Marshfield Tigers 44. Marshfield Tiger basketball on WDLB this evening. A service of Rice's Capital Carpet of Marshfield, Remax American Dream Realty of Marshfield, and Paget Equipment of Marshfield. Marshfield and Rhinelander. Boys basketball action tonight here at the Boson Company Fieldhouse. Marshfield won the JV game 47-35. Marshfield will have the basketball inbounding in backcourt in the near corner. Rhinelander applying full court pressure. Meverden into Postelik. Back to Meverden. Isaac will cross the timeline. Shovel to Bowman. Underneath to Anderson. Seth muscles it up and missed it. Knocked a man down. And a foul called on Rhinelander this time. That'll likely be on Brad Quaid. First on Quaid. Third team foul. Seth Anderson. 21 points tonight. Foul line left. Shooting two. And Seth's first try is good. 7:47 remaining. Tigers trail 50-45. Flores back in for Quaid in the Rhinelander lineup. Seth Anderson with a second free throw. He puts it up and it's good. So Seth has 23 tonight. Tigers within four. 7:45 remaining. Pressure in backcourt from Marshfield as Howard starts out on Postelik. Man-to-man defense by Marshfield. Near side, Comer has it. Still looking. Back out front once again to Howard. Heads for the far side. Back to Comer on the near wing. To the circle. Hands back to Flores. Back outside, White. Picked up by Anderson. They swing far side to Howard once again. Can't find Schickert down low. Still holds it. Out front once again. Comer fakes the three on Bowman. Starts to drive. Spins the lane. Off-balance shot up and missed. Tipped up and missed by Comer. But he's fouled on the putback. Boy, the Tigers had two men below the basket. They allowed Comer to sneak in there for an offensive rebound. Foul called on Postelik. Third on Anthony. Sixth team foul. Number 20, Anthony Postelik. Brad Comer shooting two. His first try is no good. Leader back in for Schickert in the Rhinelander lineup. 7:08 remaining in regulation time. And Marshfield trails 50-46. One more free throw for Brad Comer. It is away and missed. Long rebound claimed by Postelik. Marshfield can cut that lead down to two here. Reed Miller in front court. Far side to Postelik. Bowman back to Miller on the near wing. 2-3 zone by Rhinelander. They're presenting some pressure on the outside. Postelik at the far hash mark. Facing a double team. Comes near side to Bowman. Miller baseline. Cross court feed to Postelik. In the lane to Bowman. Kicks back out to Anderson. Seth has no shot. Although he's matched up against the much smaller Flores. Bowman on the cut to Anderson. Foul line jumper rims and falls out of there. Tipped up and missed by Meverden. Bowman flies in for the rebound. Gets tied up. Boy, some great hustle there by Meverden and Bowman. But possession goes to Rhinelander. Now five rebounds for Isaac Meverden, who's averaging 5.1 per game. Marshfield with some backcourt pressure. Howard in backcourt starts out for Rhinelander. Harassed by Postelik, gets a screen, comes across the line, and a Rhinelander timeout. Hodags take their third timeout, 6:19 remaining in regulation time, and our score is Rhinelander 50 and the Marshfield Tigers 46. We'll come back to the Boson Company Fieldhouse and more basketball in just a moment.
If you're one of the lucky ones, you've never had an auto accident. But if and when you do, you get flustered and exasperated dealing with the insurance company and getting estimates, not to mention trying to figure out how you're going to get around without your vehicle. Well, they can't make that process fun, but they can make it a lot easier. At Art's Body Shop, free estimates, free courtesy car, all worry-free. Pick up or drop off your rental from Penske Truck, too, at Art's Body Shop, South Central Avenue in Marshfield, just north of Wildwood Park.
Get organized with your bookkeeping and tax supplies from Marshfield Book and Stationery today. They have all the essentials every business needs, such as storage file, budget books, calendars, calculators, and supplies. Also appointment books, file cabinets, computer supplies, printer cartridges, expanding files, mileage, and payroll books, just to mention a few of the necessities you'll find at Marshfield Book and Stationery, M11 West McMillan in Marshfield. Stop in and see them today or call 715-387-1286. Store hours are Monday through Friday, 8 to 5.
Tigers trail by 4, 6:19 left in regulation time. Rhinelander ball, front court right. Leader across the timeline hits Howard. Man-to-man defense by Marshfield. Comer outside the arc. Looking for White. He's being harassed. Now out top, here's a three-pointer by Howard. Missed. White with the long rebound and a reach-in foul on Meverden. Owen White with those long arms grabs the long rebound, and Meverden then reaches in on him. Four fouls on Isaac, seventh team foul. Puts Owen White on the foul line where he is 3 of 3 tonight. He'll have a 1-1. Bryce Schickert back in for Brock Leader in the Rhinelander lineup. White a left-hander. He'll play at Michigan Tech next season. His first foul shot is going to roll out of there, however, and rebounded by Reed Miller. That's 8 rebounds for Reed tonight. Tigers down by 4. Miller comes to front court, and he pushes off on Comer coming across the timeline. Offensive foul on Reed Miller, his second, 8th team foul. Tigers now have 8 turnovers in the second half, 15 for the ball game. John Rangel back in for Meverden as Isaac picked up that 4th foul. Tigers down by 4, 5:55 left. Rhinelander has the ball back. Howard gets a screen, comes across the timeline. To the near side. Downstairs, White backs in on Anderson. On the cut inside, the ball's knocked down, stolen by Bowman. Ahead to Miller. Reed on the run out. He'll drive, lay it up, and miss it. But there's some contact and a Rhinelander foul. That call on Brad Comer, and that will be 5 fouls on Comer. Brad Comer fouls out with 5:37 remaining. He leaves without scoring tonight. And Brock Leader back in. Reed Miller, 1 of 3 on the foul line tonight. Shooting 2, line left. His first try rolls around, falls out. 5:37 left in regulation time. Rhinelander leads 50-46. Reed Miller with a second free throw. And he fires, and this one is no good as well. And rebounded by Schickert. Reed now just 1 of 5 on the foul line tonight. Normally shoots 74% from the free throw line. Rhinelander has it back. Here's White to the baseline. Leans in. Short jumper up and good. 26 for Owen White. Rhinelander back up by 6 with 5:20 remaining. Miller coming to front court for the Tigers. Spins out top. Needs some help. Reed lobs it underneath to Anderson. Seth is open and missed the lay-in but was fouled. Tigers have missed a few layups tonight. Reese Flores on that foul, his first. 6th team foul. Seth Anderson, 3 of 3 on the foul line tonight, shooting 2. Seth is ready. First foul shot is short. Boy. Tigers just 3 of 7 on the foul line here in the second half. 5:09 left. Tigers trail 52-46. Second foul shot by Anderson is good. Seth now with 24 tonight. Tigers down by 5. Rhinelander on the attack. Howard across the center stripe. Out top, Owen White picked up by Anderson. Near side to Howard. Gets a screen from White, and here is a push somewhere. Call against Rhinelander. We've had a lot of off-the-ball fouls tonight. Boy, Norm Kanoff would be proud tonight. That's on Owen White for a moving screen, his second foul. 17 foul. Right there with some pressure, but Postola comes across the timeline. Out top to Reed Miller. 4:45 left, Rhinelander by five. And Rhinelander wrapping up the pressure here. Weigel baseline to Postola, can't get the shot off. Double team in the corner. Needs some help, and White takes the ball away. Tigers 16th turnover and ninth of the second half. Rhinelander by five, 4.5 to play. Far side, Flores fakes the three. Downstairs, Schickert backs in and banks it off the glass. No good over Weigel, but John fouled him on the shot. First foul on John Weigel, ninth team foul. And Bryce Schickert, 3 of 4 on the foul line tonight. We'll get two here. Tigers at one point led 40-31. Since then, a 21-7 run for Rhinelander. Schickert's first free throw is off the rim and in. 4:25 remaining. Rhinelander leads 52-47. Bryce Schickert, 6'3 junior. Only man on this roster above 6'1, aside from White, who is 6'5. Schickert with a second foul shot. Puts it up and it's good. Schickert with 5 points all on the foul line. Marshfield again down by six. Bowman in backcourt. He'll take it across the timeline. Facing a double team. Far side to Miller. Reed double teamed out top. Dribbles to the near side. Back out front. Bowman once again. Anderson in the far corner. Cross court feed. Knocked down to the timeline. Grabbed again by Bowman. Shovels back to Anderson at the far hash mark. Seth holds it. Still looking for some help here. Now Miller on the near side. Baseline Bowman open for three-pointer. It's good. A big three there for Brant Bowman. His 17th of the year. Tigers within three with 3:45 left in regulation time. Rhinelander to forecourt. Howard far side. Stopped by Postolik on the cut to White. Down the lane. Leans in. Off-balance shot. Rolls in and he's fouled as well. Owen White with 28. Basket is good. Foul called on Weigel. Second on John, 10th team foul. Isaac Meverden back in for John Weigel. And Owen White on the foul line to our right, attempting a three-point play. Rhinelander back up by five. And the free throw is no good. Long rebound claimed by Anderson. Tigers have the ball down by five, 3:35 remaining. Anderson bumped in backcourt, comes across to Miller. Facing a double team on the far sideline. Reed back out front to the far side of the baseline. Cross-court feed Bowman, near side to Postolik. Anderson back in the circle, double team there. Needs some help, and a reach-in foul coming, I believe, against Rhinelander. They're double teaming right near that foul line. That might be on Leader. Second foul on Leader. Eighth team foul, Seth Anderson. 4 of 5 on the foul line tonight, shooting a 1-1. And Seth's first try is good. Seth Anderson with 25 tonight, 3:17 remaining. Tigers trail 55-51. Seth Anderson with a second free throw. He fires and it's good. Marshfield back to within three, putting on pressure. Howard in backcourt starts up the floor on Postolik. Moves across the timeline. Gets a screen out top. Drives the lane. Leans in. Scoop shot up. And again, right to the basket for two. Easy basket for Junior Howard. Again, Rhinelander by five. 3 minutes to play. Miller comes across the timeline for Marshfield. Stopped out front. Looking for some help. Near side to Postolik. Back out front to Reed Miller. They go baseline to Anderson. Looking for a cutter down low. Now double team in the corner. And drops the ball out of bounds off of Flores. Rhinelander brings Haug and Quade back in for Flores and Leader. 2:40 remaining. And Rhinelander leading 57-52. Marshfield to inbound, sideline front court. Postolik will throw it in. Comes into Miller along the far sideline. Reed double teamed immediately. Dribbles back out front with it. Harassed by Haug, starts to drive, leans in and goes baseline past Bowman out of bounds. Tigers have 10 turnovers in the second half and 17 for the ballgame. 2:30 left. Rhinelander by 5. They have the ball back. White starts out on Anderson. Moves into forecourt for the Hodags to the far side. White one-on-one with Anderson. Picks up his dribble. Back out top again to Quade. Defense by Bowman. Near side hits Howard outside the arc. White has it back top of the key. 2:10 left. Rhinelander by 5. White at the foul line. Hands back to Howard. He'll back it out. Now White holds it once again. He'll drive the foul line down the lane. Stop there. Leans in, has no shot. Comes back out to Howard with 1:55 left. And Rhinelander up by 5. Howard, a three-point try, up and no good. And the rebound cleared by Miller. Baseball pass to Bowman behind the defense. He'll drive and miss the lay-in. Rebound back up and missed by Miverton. But Isaac fouled on the play. Tigers again miss some close-in shots, but they'll get free throws here. Junior Howard commits the foul, his third. Ninth team foul, Isaac Miverton. 2 of 2 on the foul line tonight. Line left for 2. Isaac set. And the first free throw is around and it falls off. Reese Flores returns for Rhinelander for Jared Haug. 1:45 remaining in regulation time. Tigers trail 57-52. Miverton with a second foul shot. On the way and around and out again. Ball slapped loose by Miller. Comes back out to Anderson. Seth on the drive is held. That ball was secured by a Rhinelander man. Miller just slapped it loose. Tipped it back outside to Miller and to Anderson, rather, and then Seth fouled going to the basket. That foul is on Owen White, his third, 10th team foul, and so Seth Anderson gets 2 more free throws. Each team now in the double bonus. Seth Anderson shooting 2. First by Seth is away, and it's going to roll off. 1:40 remaining in regulation time. Tigers trail 57-52. Tigers have missed 7 foul shots here in the second half. One more for Seth Anderson. This shot is up and in. So Seth now has 27, and Marshfield wants a timeout. Marshfield timeout, the Tigers' third timeout with 1:40 remaining in regulation time. Rhinelander leading 57-53. Marshfield Tiger basketball this evening, a service of Filker Brothers Corporation of Marshfield, manufacturers of stainless steel products, and they support all youth sports and activities. Participation in high school sports builds character and teamwork, and Filker Brothers of Marshfield supports the youth of Central Wisconsin. Tigers led by 9 at one point here in the second half. But then Rhinelander with a 16-0 run. They've led all the way since, and they're up by 4 with 1:41 remaining. Tigers out with Anderson, Bowman, Miverton, Riegel, and Miller. Rhinelander inbounding, baseline backcourt. Tigers have turned the ball over 10 times here in the second half, 17 for the ballgame. Flores will throw it in. Comes into Howard, deep in backcourt. Starts out now on Anthony Postolik. Moves across the 10-second line off a screen from White. Near side to Quade. Brings it back out on Bowman. 1:25 remaining. Quade down the lane. Is back out to Flores. 1:20 left. Rhinelander by 4. Howard on the near wing. Gets a screen from White. Hands back to White. He'll drive down the lane. Comes back outside again. Quade with it and a reach-in foul on Bowman. First on Brandt. That puts Brad Quade on the foul line where he is 2 of 2 tonight. And he'll get 2 free throws here with 1:10 remaining. Quade set. First foul shot is good. 1:10 left in regulation time, and Rhinelander leads 58-53. Second free throw now for Brad Quade. And that shot on the way and rolls around, falls out. Miller there for the rebound. We've got Reed now with 10 rebounds. He dribbles back to front court. He'll drive to the foul line. Baseline to Bowman. Three-pointer by Brand is up and in. A big three for Brand Bowman, and Marshfield takes time. Marshfield timeout. Marshfield's fourth timeout. 58 seconds remaining in regulation time. And our score now, Rhinelander 58, Marshfield 56. Back with more basketball in just a moment.
When you think about it, investing is more than just money. You're trying to achieve something important for you or your family. That goal could be a comfortable retirement, college, or protecting your family. But here's the real question. What's important to you? Hi, I'm Randy Gershman, your Marshfield Edward Jones Financial Advisor. Setting a specific, realistic goal is the first step, and I can help. Contact me today at 715-387-8662. See for yourself how Edward Jones makes sense of investing. Edward Jones, member SIPC.
Rail transport has grown every year since 1962. A leader in environmental initiatives, human resource practices, one of the safest providers of truckload services in the United States. At Rail, people are the power of red. We focus on delivering customer satisfaction, providing flawless transportation service, and maintaining excellent safety standards. If you'd like to be the power of red, call Rail Transport 715-591-3795 and Equal Opportunity Affirmative Action Employer.
58 seconds remaining in regulation time. Rhinelander leads Marshfield 58-56. Rhinelander inbounding baseline backcourt. Flores looking, comes into Howard deep in backcourt. Ahead to Flores, he'll cross the timeline and a reach-in foul on Anderson. Third foul on Seth. Rhinelander is in the double bonus. Memphrey will come back in for Marshfield. Reese Flores has not tried a free throw yet tonight. Shooting two on the line to our right. And his first attempt is around and in. Mifferton back in for Urban for the Tigers. 53 seconds left in regulation time. Rhinelander leads 59-56. One more foul shot for Reese Flores, up and in. Again, Rhinelander by four, putting on backcourt pressure. Miller behind the line, lobs across the timeline to Bowman. Ball knocked loose, stolen by White. Pass ahead to Quade. He has a run out. He'll drive and lay it in. Rhinelander scores off the turnover. Hodang's back up by six. Here's Anderson to front court for Marshfield. Going baseline, and he's held and fouled, I believe, by Schickert. Fouls on Bryce Schickert, his third foul. And Seth Anderson back on the foul line for two more. Seth's first free throw is good. 31 seconds remaining. Tigers trail 62-57. Grant Urban back in for Meverden. Isaac has four fouls here. Second free throw for Seth Anderson. And the shot up, around, and in. Marshfield down by four. 30 seconds to play. Putting on backcourt pressure. White has it slapped loose out of bounds and last hit by White as Miller and Anderson provide double team pressure along the baseline. Now Meverden right back in for Urban. 26 seconds remaining and the Tigers will inbound. Baseline front court down by four. Meverden will throw in. Lobs near side to Bowman. In the corner, Miller. Three-point try is up off the rim, and it falls in. Tigers back to within one, and Marshfield takes a timeout. This is Marshfield's final timeout. 20 seconds remaining in regulation time, and our score, Rhinelander 62, Marshfield 61. More basketball in just a moment.
An excellent team is built from the ground up. It starts with a solid foundation, support among its members, and the development of a winning tradition. If you're planning to build or remodel, think of the tradition offered at Trudeau Construction of Marshfield. They handle everything from new homes to additions, remodeling projects, kitchens and baths, cabinets, wood floors, decks, and gazebos. Have a project in mind? Plan it from the ground up by dialing 387-2239 for Trudeau Construction, Marshfield.
What one person do you trust most? Your spouse? Your minister? Your doctor?
How about the guy that fixes my car?
Your auto mechanic?
Yeah, Scott and the guys at Jim's Auto in Marshfield. They look things over and tell me what's wrong, both serious and not so serious, so I know what needs fixing now and what can wait a bit. I get an honest, competitive estimate. And when I decide what to do, well, they stand behind their work, too. Real professionals. Jim's Auto in Marshfield, 710 East Depot Street, just off Peach, north of the tracks. If you can't trust your auto mechanic, Who can you trust?
Tigers back to within one with 20 seconds remaining in regulation time, and Rhinelander inbounding. Baseline backcourt. Flores will throw it in for the Hodags. Looking, running the baseline. Comes into Quade, and he's bumped and fouled by Bowman. Second foul on Brant Bowman. Each team is in the double bonus. Brad Quade, who is 3 of 4 on the foul line tonight, will be on the line to our right, attempting two free throws. Tigers are out of timeouts. Quade shooting two. His first attempt is good. 19 seconds left in regulation time. Rhinelander leads 63-61. Meverden back in for Urban in the Marshfield lineup. Quade with a second free throw. On the way, and good. Rhinelander by three with 19 seconds left. Tigers need a three to tie. Miller across the timeline. Across the timeline with 14. Anderson far side with 12, 11, 10. Back out top, Postolik. Miverden, pass stolen by Quade, knocked out of bounds off of Quade. 5 seconds remaining. 5 seconds left in regulation time. Marshfield down by three. Tigers do not have a timeout. Tigers need a three-pointer to tie the ball game. Miller in backcourt with 4, 3, 2, 1. A long three is up and short as time expires. And the Rhinelander Hodags, thanks to a 16-0 run midway through the second half, come from behind to win this ball game tonight by three. Some men's basketball action on the college level tomorrow. UW-Stevens Point men at River Falls to take on Auburndale's Isaac Castellano and the River Falls Ball Club. UW-Platteville men featuring Marshfield's Matt Ostreich playing at Stout tomorrow. UW-Eau Claire men featuring Tyler Furlinger of Columbus beating La Crosse at Eau Claire tomorrow evening. UW-Oshkosh men with Marshfield's Adam Fravert having a great season will play at home against Whitewater tomorrow night. The Midland College of Nebraska men, coached by Nielsville's Oliver Drake at Hastings of Nebraska. And the Marquette men play at Providence tomorrow evening. Game time 5:30. That broadcast 5 o'clock tomorrow evening right here on AM 1450 WDLB and on WDLBWOSQ.com. Our final score this evening, the Rhinelander Hodag 64, Marshfield Tigers 61. We'll have a full recap on our postgame report coming up in just a moment.
You always get
that winter grime off your car at the Balthus Full Service Car Wash in Marshfield. It includes interior floor and mats vacuumed, door jams dried to prevent freeze-up, windows cleaned, all done in minutes by professionals only at the Balthus Car Wash, right across from Heinz and Printing, downtown Marshfield. Open 7 days a week, weather permitting.
You always get home.
Victory Apparel of Marshfield is the place to go for all your hometown team apparel. New styles are arriving daily for every high school team in the area, as well as your favorite college team. Check out their NCAA team hoodies. Victory Apparel, just south of the tracks on Central Avenue in Marshfield. Your official fanwear store for high school and NCAA team apparel. Plus, custom screen printing and embroidery for schools, organizations, and businesses.
Well, the Marshfield Tigers led this ball game by 9. Midway through the second half, things look pretty good for Marshfield. Rhinelander called the timeout, came out and scored 16 straight points, and that was it. Marshfield played come-from-behind basketball the rest of the night, could not catch the Hodags, and Rhinelander wins it tonight by 3, 64-61. By the way, the Tiger boys basketball team returns to action next Friday night, this Friday night in Schofield against DC Everest. Game time 7:15. Our broadcast begins Friday at 7 p.m. right here on AM 1450 WDLB and on WDLBWOSQ.com. The win goes to Rhinelander this evening by a final score of 64-61. We'll come back and talk with Tiger coach Scott Scheuer and review the final scoring and stats in this ball game right after these messages.
Hey truckers, you only have one chance to make a first impression, right? So you better make sure your truck's body is looking fine. At V&H, Wisconsin's most complete heavy truck body shop, we've got 16 certified technicians and support staff. And from major collision repair to our 65-foot Garmat spray booth, we've got your entire body covered. You'll drive out of V&H proud and ready to take on the world. V&H, the driving force in heavy trucks and equipment.
Find us at 1505 South Central Avenue, Marshfield, or vhtrucks.com.
Your wedding anniversary, it's a special celebration, and a special celebration calls for nothing but the best. Premium Hefco Roses. Hi, this is Liz from Hefco Floral Company, reminding you not to forget that special day and to make it memorable with beautiful long-stem fresh roses. Call 387-1129 today and order our Premium Hefco Roses. Hefco Floral Company, open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5:30, and Saturdays, 8 till noon. Hefco's, your florist, we help you celebrate your life.
Rhinelander Hodags winners over Marshfield this evening, 64-61. And our postgame stats, a service of the people for whom numbers matter the most, Edward Jones Investments of Marshfield. See Randy Gershman or Brian Kaiser for their sound investment advice. Rhinelander led by Owen White, who finishes this evening with 28 points. White this evening had 11 baskets. Three of those were threes. He was 3 of 5 on the foul line. Brad Quaid matched his season high with 13 points. Quaid had 4 baskets, was 5 of 6 on the free throw line. Junior Howard with 11 points tonight. Howard had 4 baskets, and 3 of those were 3s. Bryce Schickert, 5 points, 5 of 6 on the foul line. Reese Flores, 5 points, a 3-point basket, 2 of 2 on free throws. Brock Leader, a 3-point basket for 3. Brad Comer did not score. Comer missed 2 free throws for Rhinelander. And Jared Haug also played but did not score for the Hodags in this one tonight. Marshfield Tigers led by Seth Anderson. Seth with a career-high 31 points tonight. Seth had 10 baskets, 2 or 3s, 9 of 12 on the free throw line. Reed Miller, 16 points. Reed had 6 baskets, 3 of those were 3s, 1 of 5 on the foul line. Brant Bowman, 10 points, 4 baskets, 2 or 3s. Brant in double figures for the 7th time this year. Isaac Miverdon, 2 of 4 on the foul line for 2. Tommy Olson, a basket for 2. Tommy missed a free throw. Grant Urban did not score. Anthony Postolik did not score. John Reigel did not score. Tigers on the foul line, only 12 of 21. Rhinelander, 15 of 21. Tigers also turned the ball over 18 times in this ballgame, including 11 times in the second half. Rhinelander had 9 turnovers for the ballgame. Marshfield had the lead at halftime, 33-31. Rhinelander outscored Marshfield in the second half, 33-28. Marshfield's biggest lead was 9. Rhinelander's biggest lead was 8. We were tied at 26-31. And had 5 lead changes in this ballgame. In fact, we were tied at 31. And then Marshfield scored 9 straight to go up 40-31. And then Rhinelander scored 16 straight to take command of the ballgame. And Marshfield played catch-up the rest of the evening. So after that 40-31 edge, Rhinelander outscored Marshfield 33-21 the rest of the way. And Rhinelander wins it tonight by 3, 64-61. Our coverage of Marshfield Tiger basketball this evening on a WDLB, a service of Silky Electronics in Chile, Citizen State Bank of Loyal, Granton, Nielsville, Spencer, and Marshfield, and the House of Heating in Marshfield. I want to remind you also that Tiger Basketball is a service of the Baltus Bread and Butter Shops in Marshfield. When you gas up at the Marshfield Tiger or Columbus Dawn Pride Pumps on North Central Avenue next to Walgreens, 2 cents per gallon is given to that school system. That's at the Baltus Bread and Butter Shop on North Central Avenue next to Walgreens in Marshfield. JV contest this evening won by Marshfield 47-35. Rhinelander wins this one tonight by 3, 64-61. We'll bring in Tiger basketball coach Scott Scheuer to get some comments on the ball game as the Tigers lose this one by 3 this evening for 2 of this Rhinelander ball club. Coach, a tough one tonight. It looked like you were in good position in this one this evening. Then things kind of fell apart there midway through the second half. Tell us your thoughts about what you saw this evening.
Well, up 9, they called timeout, and you know, we made a few adjustments, and I probably shouldn't have. They go on a 16-0 run, down 7. We battled back. It came down to free throws and turnovers, and Owen White is a really, really good player. I know he doesn't get a lot of exposure playing in Rhinelander, and I was just talking to Coach about that, but he's as good as we've seen, and they do a really good job of getting him the ball where he can make plays.
In the first half, it seemed like things went your way pretty well. They put on some zone presses against you. You seemed to handle that pretty well, so things were going well there in the first half.
Yeah, we had 6 turnovers at half, and really, I think maybe one was against their full court pressure. We were turning it over on the half court and just running our offense and not being as patient as I would have hoped. You know, and again, when you play a really good team, the margin for error is slim, and we just didn't make the plays down the stretch. And, you know, like I've said to you before, we just got to clean that up. And as we, you know, progress in our season here, can't keep making those same mistakes.
And your ball club, as you mentioned, up by 9 midway through the second half, then things kind of fell apart with that 16-0 run. What are some things that Rhinelander did during that stretch that made it difficult for your ball club?
They made shots. We didn't. Free throws. They made their last 8 free throws. We were 12 for 20. And typically we're a 75-76% free throw shooting team, and we just didn't make free throws tonight and turned it over. So when you don't get shots, and then when you do and they foul you and you don't make them pay, it's really tough, you know, to not only get a lead but maintain.
And as you mentioned, you were up by 9. They came right back, and I think White had scored at least the first 8 in that run, that 16-0 run. So, boy, he's a nice weapon to have on
their
side.
Yeah, he was 4 for 4. He scored 8. He had 2 threes from that one three that he hit was from long range. And you know, when you play good defense, you're right in his face. I thought Grant Urban did a really good job of making him work for his shots. He just made shots, and you know, you got to tip your hat to him and Rhinelander, and you know, get back to practice and clean some things up.
All right. Well, Coach, thanks for coming by. We'll see you on Friday night.
Thanks, Gene.
Tiger basketball coach Scott Scheuer with us. Marshfield falling to Rhinelander this evening by 3, 64-61. We'll come back with more from the Boson Company Fieldhouse in just a moment.
Buying a home can make you feel like a mouse in an endless maze. Wrong turn here, wrong turn there. At Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation, they want to guide you through every turn to help you find the cheese.
This is Todd Schultz with Fairway Mortgage. We want to be your trusted lender for life. We work with FHA, VA, WIDA, USDA, conventional, and reverse mortgage loans. Come in today or call us to set up an appointment. We'll review all your options. You get more home loan solutions with Fairway of Marshfield.
Fairway is your local mortgage specialist. Visit Fairway at 211 South Central Avenue, downtown Marshfield. Also on the internet at fairwaymarshfield.com. Or call them today, 715-384-7878, and like them on Facebook.
Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation, NMLS 2289, is an equal housing lender. All rights reserved. Not an offer to enter into an agreement. Not all customers will qualify. Information, rates, and programs are subject to change without notice. Other restrictions and limitations apply. Todd Schultz, NMLS number 642092.
Have a couple of other scores to mention for you. First of all, the Wisconsin Badger men's basketball team did win tonight, knocking off Indiana 71-61. Ethan Happ led Wisconsin with 28 points and 9 rebounds. Also, a girls basketball score from earlier today. Greenwood and Cornell are playing a girls and boys doubleheader at Cornell this evening, and Arnie Peck from our WDLB staff drove over to Cornell to watch those games this evening, and he reports that Greenwood won the girls' game tonight, defeating Cornell 52-39, so a big win for the Greenwood girls in that one this evening. JV contest here in Marshfield tonight, won by Marshfield 47-35. Rhinelander with this win improves to 8-1. Marshfield now 5-5. The Tigers return to Wisconsin Valley Conference basketball action Friday night with a game in Schofield against D.C. Everest. Tip-off at 7:15. That broadcast begins at 7 p.m. Friday evening on AM 1450 WDLB and on WDLBWOSQ.com. On Thursday evening, the Tiger girls basketball team here at the Fieldhouse against Everest. Tip-off 7 p.m. That broadcast, or 7:15 rather, that broadcast 7 p.m. Thursday evening here on WDLB. Tomorrow on WDLB, Big East men's basketball as Marquette plays at Providence. Coverage of that game begins at 5 o'clock tomorrow evening right here on AM 1450 WDLB and on WDLBWOSQ.com. We'll also have Cloverbelt Conference girls basketball on WOSQ on Thursday night as Nielsville plays at Columbus. That broadcast 7 p.m. on Thursday evening on 92.3 FM WOSQ and on WDLBWOSQ.com. Thanks once again to our producer, Tom Uthmeyer, for his work this evening. And thanks to our sponsors of Marshfield Tiger Basketball on WDLB, including Arts Body Shop in Marshfield, Marshfield Book and Stationery, and Edward Jones Investments of Marshfield. I'm Gene DeLisio. That's it from the Boson Company Fieldhouse in Marshfield. Our final score once again tonight, the Rhinelander Hodag 64 and the Marshfield Tigers 61.
It's Marshfield Tigers basketball.
Tiger basketball on WDLB is sponsored by First Choice Credit Union, Total Electric Service, Trudeau Construction, Comfort Systems of Marshfield, Marshfield Utilities, and Shriners Plumbing and Heating. It's Marshfield Tiger basketball on AM 1450.
WDLB.
I wish they all could be California. too hot lady. Gotta run for shelter, gotta run for shade. It's too hot,
too hot,
too hot lady. Gotta cool this anger from this mess that we made.